Hi guys, so today I got two packages. You can see. There's one. There's two. So we're going to do a small little box opening today. I'm putting this on my phone. I don't know where my little SD card is to download video from my other camera, so haven't been using it. I'm looking for it. That's why I haven't taken any writing videos, because I can't find it, so I can't upload the video. I might have to buy another SD thing. We'll see. Anyways, so let me flip the camera around and open some packages.
Is
the vet tech stuff I bought for Sassy for her feet. So, let's see. I'm sorry if this video is crap because I'm holding it one hand and I have the worst eye-hand coordination in the name of history. So. Wiggly, wiggly. So this stuff I ordered some stuff for Sassy so that I could make her an artificial shoe to keep her sound so that I could ride her every day. So. Oh, puppies. I bought the contouring plastic. This is for her soul guard. Soul guard I already have in the kitchen. Let me go grab that real quick. Okay, so here's the soul guard that I ordered. And this is to like it says here, it's for soul protection and support. It's black. And basically you put this on the bottom of their feet to kind of give them a pad so that they're not sensitive to the ground. And then these are the mixing tips that come with it. So I got those, package of 12. I'll probably need 8 of those. And this is the super fast, which is instant shoes and full extension. So if you have a baby horse that doesn't have good feet, you put this on there and it keeps them sound. But this is gonna be used for the instant shoes for Sassy. And then this, of course, the contouring plastic is for the sole guard. This right here, is expensive then. Like I mentioned before, I had ordered the soul garden stuff, but I didn't order the dispensing gun, so I had to wait for that to come in. So open this guy up. And if you ever ordered anything from Vet Tech before, you know it's not the cheapest thing. Basically. I think I paid somewhere around a little bit over $120 for everything, which isn't bad. I mean, if you get shoes put on your horse plus barrier, some people pay like $100 every 2 weeks, every 6 weeks. Don't want to do that. So here's my nifty dispensing gun. And so nice and shiny. The dispensing gun itself was like $50, I think. I don't even know. Yeah, the dispensing gun was like a $53. So the cartridges go in there. Has two tippy things here to help squirt it out, because every cartridge has two holes. You see that? Two holes, and you need a specialized gun for that. So that's that package. Put everything back in here. That way I can open it. I'll take this out to the barn and do horse feet later. Okay, so this one is Fancy's new bit. The orbitless that I ordered her. It came super quick, like within a couple of days actually, which is pretty cool considering that I was expecting it for like at least, you know, bring this around there. I'm using a fingernail file, people. Not the best thing to use, but again, there it is. That's everything. Make sure my envelope is empty. There's a card. So, here's a card. Focus. There. So that's what it looks like on the horse. And I bought it, as you can tell, from the UK. And it's a bitless horse. Advances, sales, hiring. I guess this is what they do, but there's bridle specialists. So I will definitely be trying the bit out later on Fancy. So, alright, so it came with an extra nose band. It says, thank you for purchasing the Orbitless bridle. To begin using it, you will need to attach it to the cheek pieces of your regular bridle. Start by connecting the cheek pieces of your bridle through the slots halfway or midway between the noseband and chin strap. Attach the reins through the slots below the chin strap. The reins can be attached in different positions, please. Well, you have to look online for that. Disconnect the left hand chin strap before putting the bridle on the horse's head. Disconnect. Okay. Okay. Adjust the cheek pieces and noseband so that the ellipses. My brain does not comprehend that word. Are halfway between the prominent cheekbones and the corner of the mouth. Ensure that the noseband is located centrally on the bony part of the nose. Like that picture. So right in between the two, which makes sense. You don't want it too high, you don't want it too low, and you want it on the bone because you don't want, oh god, I'm yawning. You don't want to damage the horse at all. Reconnect the left hand chin strap and tighten so that one finger can be comfortably inserted between the chin strap and the jaw. Okay? Hopefully your bridle now matches the one in the photograph. So there. Pretty cool. And this is another fleece or wool. Ooh. It's floofy. Nice and soft. Bet it won't stay clean for too long. This definitely feels like wool. I'm pretty sure it's cool. Anyway, so here's the other part of the card. And it has the rein position side pull above the chin strap, minimal reins first slot below the chin strap, mild reins between chin strap and noseband, and moderate reins below noseband. So in the vertical position, the contact emphasis is on the pole and chin. All the above configurations can be set up with the uncomprehendable word in the horizontal position when the contact emphasis on the nose and chin. So in the vertical, for the most effective rein alignment, it is recommended that rein clips are used for position 3 or 4. Vertical. So I'm guessing 1 is where you want it. As far as nose and pole, if you look at how it pulls there, that's pretty cool. I'm gonna keep this little fleece inside the thing, and I think, yep, it's actually real wool. I can smell it. It smells like sheep, and I know that's sheep smell because I have sheep now. Should throw in the box. Okay, so here is the piece of leather assistance. So, and it's full leather. I decided to get one. So I got the horse-sized black. Look at this. So, okay, so it's Velcroed on there. Oh, I like that. Sorry. That means I can take it off and wash it. Which many things don't have that option. They're either sewn on or stitched on, and then you can't clean it. Got a little fuzzies here. Oh, this is so soft. I love it. So soft. If you like wool like I do, that is awesome. So, it's about a good inch thick. It's a shame it's gonna get dirty. Okay, so it's wool leather. It has this little buckle here. And here is the piece. I love how it looks. So this is where the reins connect. So when you pull on it, depending on where your chin strap is, when you pull on it, it just kind of pushes pressure on the nose here. And then on the pole, which would be, if I look on the picture, this will be your cheek pieces. So when you pull, it's going to pull it that way. So and here's the chin strap. Looks like just a regular chin buckle thingy. Nice leather. I'm gonna have to oil these before I use it though, so they don't dry out that quickly. But isn't that cool looking? I can't wait to use it on Fancy. See how she does. She's really good. I rode her in my Monty Roberts dually halter last night. She's really good, but this will definitely be an improvement. So anyways, so there was my little box opening. So I can't wait to use it on Fancy. I'm pretty sure she'll do really good on it. I'm going to have to use or find a bridle cover or something for it because I don't want it to get moldy. The humidity here will destroy leather pretty quickly. So I really like how it looks. I like the wool and stuff, and I don't want it getting damaged. It wasn't the cheapest thing to buy, so I definitely want to protect it. Just like with all my other bits, none of them have ever been under $150. So I put good money into them, so I want to make sure that they're all protected. I might actually have to buy a bridle bag for every single bridle that I have just to protect them all. Anyways, leave your comments down below what you think. I will try to post a riding video of me later with Fancy. Nothing too crazy, just because I don't want to overwork her. She is supposed to have the next couple of weeks off, so I will probably just do a little bit walk trot later with some stopping and backing just to see how she reacts to it. It's definitely going to be a different feel for her, but if this works for her really good, then I don't have to worry about using a bit in her mouth. So it's going to be new learning again, so we'll see. Anyways, leave your comments down below. Let me know what you think, and I will see you guys later. Again, helmets on, heels down, and be safe out there. Bye.